Hey guys, welcome to another video. It's Master Aquatics. So this is the 29-gallon tank outside in my backyard, and it is freezing outside, guys. I don't even know how these fish are still alive, but that's what's so amazing about these animals, is that they can survive the cold weather. And that's why I put them outside in the first place. But change of plans, I don't want to keep these guys outside. I mean, I hardly get to see them, and I hardly ever come out here unless I need to feed them or clean their water and stuff like that. Because it's too cold, I don't like being out in the cold. Fortunately, when Albert passed away, rest in peace Albert, the 125-gallon tank is now vacant. These guys, you know, they need a big home, and a lot of you guys were saying, like, you know, there's too many fish in here anyways, and I'm gonna give them a good home, and I'm also gonna take the decorations that are in here, and I'm gonna add them to the 125-gallon tank, and see if I can make something work. Alright guys, so before I even begin, I'm going to go ahead and start aquascaping this tank. I mentioned earlier in the video that I'm going to decorate this tank with the decorations that were in the 29-gallon tank. Because the 29-gallon tank is outside and it's cold, I don't want to keep the fish out in the cold. They don't really eat or do anything. They're not active in the cold, so I'm going to bring them into the 125-gallon tank where it's warmer, and they will be a lot more active. Their metabolism will be slightly faster, and they will eat, and that's what I want to see. That's what I want. So I went ahead and I grabbed this piece of driftwood, which has some moss attached to it. It's a beautiful piece of driftwood. I paid nothing for this piece of driftwood, and I really can't believe some of the cool things that I was able to find at a stream by my house in my area, and put them in my aquarium, and it cost me $0, because I remember paying tons of money for rocks and driftwood at the local fish store, and now I look back and I'm like, I can't believe I did that. So if you guys want to do this for your aquarium as well, where you can collect rocks and wood for your aquarium for free so you can save money, I have a video where I show you guys how I got these rocks and woods from a stream and how you can clean them and use them for your tank. I'll post that video down in the description and I'll leave a link for you guys. All you got to do is just click on the link. I'm mainly focused on the right side of the aquarium. The left side is kind of done for the most part. I'm not sure what else to add to the left side. Like I said, the crawfish, they have taken that left side of the aquarium and made it their home. They live in the Anubias plants. The right side is going to be a little bit more rocky and woody, and that's what I wanted to do. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to add these rocks, and I'm going to place them all around this front piece of driftwood and make it look really cool. This is going to create some hiding places for the baitfish and the panfish, because as you guys may or may not know, panfish are extremely skittish, especially when it's their first time in an aquarium. They kind of freak out a little bit, but eventually they will get used to me. It's just going to take them some time to get used to me. It might take about, you know, 2 to 3 weeks. They'll just have to learn the feeding schedule that I give them, and they'll have to get used to me walking up to the aquarium. But they immediately fell in love with the aquarium. I mean, you can tell right away they were really happy being in this aquarium. They're not hiding. As soon as they came out of the net, they were swimming all around, exploring, you know, doing what fish do. This is the red-eared sunfish, not a red-eared slider. I made the mistake of calling them that in one of my last videos. I'm not going to do that again. But the red-eared sunfish are one of my favorite types of sunfish because they have a good color combination of purple and red and blue and orange, and they just look beautiful to me. There's also this yellow sunfish. Now, I believe that was a yellow-breasted sunfish. It's one of a kind to me. I've never really seen them. These are the bass minnows. They're nothing special. They're just feeder fish. You know, you use them to catch the bigger fish. They're not that special, but so far they're doing really good in my tank and they're growing really big. This is the yellow-breasted sunfish again. If you guys know the exact name of that fish, please let me know. So that's the current stocking of the 125-gallon tank as of right now. I will be stocking some more stuff in here later. I don't want to throw too many fish in here at once. I'm just going to use these guys right now for the aquarium until I can figure out what I want to do. I appreciate everybody's constructive criticism in the last video and everybody's feedback. I'll see you guys in the next video. Take care and bye bye.